Commissioners offered to the Beaufort Regional Medical Authority, $4.8 million for several parcels of land surrounding the hospital, and that a date for a public hearing on this particular issue be set for July the 12th.
Any discussion? All in favor of that said motion, raise your right hand. Any opposed? 7-0.
Mr. Chairman, if I might just take a minute to explain that the original proposed budget was very upfront with the idea that the Beaufort Regional Medical Authority owed to Beaufort County government in round numbers $1.6 million, it's $1.57 million as a debt service reimbursement. We've been paying debt service on behalf of Beaufort Regional Medical Authority for about 12 years, and they have always faithfully reimbursed us. But in the year that will end for us on Thursday, we have not received that $1,570-some-thousand reimbursement. So the proposed budget that was released on May 5th was predicated on the idea that we would need to adopt a tax rate of 52 cents in order to set aside a hospital debt reserve. That's on page 41 of your budget volume, if you all want to refer to that. And that effectively represented a 3-cent property tax specific to funding the hospital debt reserve in an amount of $1,573,902. The budget was also very upfront, though, back in early May, in saying that the hospital and the county were cooperatively looking for means of the hospital to be able to refinance some existing assets, debts, liabilities, that would create enough liquidity for them to pay back Beaufort County government what the hospital owed Beaufort County government. And the budget message was designed in an if-then kind of fashion that suggested if the hospital would succeed at this, then the county commissioners could debate a budget document not with a 52-cent tax rate, but with a 49-cent tax rate. So the budget anticipated all of that. Commissioner Richardson has spoken publicly about that logic on two different occasions. The idea was for the hospital to create liquidity of about $3 million using as collateral assets that they own that the county does not. The hospital would keep $1.4 million of that liquidity in order to operate during the remaining months that are necessary of the dual process, and the hospital would pay us immediately $1.6 million. So that's where those numbers come from. The hospital asked me to get involved about 3 or 4 weeks ago, given the interest of the financing institutions that the county government play a role in backing that debt in some way, backing this refinancing effort with the full faith and credit of Beaufort County government. That may take the form 3 weeks ago of an unconditional guarantee. It might take the form of Beaufort County government being a co-borrower, but regardless of what that financing instrument looked like, Beaufort County government would very much have been on the hook for that refinancing strategy. So the county commissioners conducted a closed session very recently, actually, and considered the possibility, if they were going to be on the hook for that kind of debt anyway, for the purpose of giving the hospital operating money and reimbursing the county the $1.6 million that's owed, you all directed me to play around with the idea of the county government simply taking control of all the real estate, not just the real estate that the county has owned historically, but also the real estate that is in the ownership of Beaufort Regional Medical Authority. So As a result of that, we've explored it in great detail, we've had several conference calls and meetings about that with the staff in the debt management section, the state treasurer's office. Everybody's agreed that provided that we can get a competitive financing proposal, that the LGC would consider that kind of financing and that kind of property purchase at its regular August meeting. I'm comfortable enough with the assurances that we've had in the last 3 weeks that provided we are, Beaufort County government is now a willing buyer of the real estate assets that Beaufort County Hospital owns. So you are publicly directing us to make an offer to Beaufort Regional Medical Authority of $4.8 million to purchase approximately 19 parcels, which represents real estate assets that they own, that they only owe $1.8 million on to an existing lending institution. So if we purchase those parcels for $4.8 million, they only owe $1.8 million, we're going to create $3 million in liquidity, immediately get paid back $1.6 million, the hospital is going to keep $1.4 million to operate over the next several months, and we will have accomplished the refinancing vision that was outlined as long ago as March. So I guess the question for the taxpayer, the county taxpayer, is what consequence does this have? You know, is there anything that you did not anticipate months ago when you started this process? The answer is yes. The county government didn't anticipate being so deeply involved in the refinancing instrument. So as a result, we're now confronted with a new debt service payment, a new mortgage on these assets that we are attempting to purchase. So if we in fact are a willing buyer, and we in fact do have a willing seller in the form of the Regional Medical Authority, then we will be taking on responsibility for a 15-year term debt service payment on a $4.8 million principal, which comes out to be something like $542,000, assuming that the debt is qualified as tax exempt, and we think that it will be. So the budget document did not assume that the county government would make this purchase of these assets. It's obviously in the county government's interest to own all of the real estate so that we become the gatekeeper of future tenants that might occupy the hospital grounds. But we have to make this unanticipated debt service payment in the coming fiscal year, provided that this borrowing gets approved in the month of August. So what's the consequence? The consequence is that I think you're free to debate a general fund budget that has in it not a tax rate of 52 cents, but a tax rate of 50 cents. So effectively, you're missing your revenue neutral target of 48.2, not by 8/10 of a penny, which is where we thought you would be if we succeeded in refinancing, but you're missing it by 1.8 tenths of a penny because you are making an offer to purchase real estate and taking on a new debt service payment as opposed to simply being a party to a refinancing agreement. So my recommended budget still stands, which is a recommended rate of 52 cents, and it assumes pessimistically that you will not succeed in this purchase of real estate or any refinancing of any kind that allows you to be reimbursed the $1.6 million that you're owed. So my recommended budget still stands in that pessimistic fashion. But I'm now telling you that since we published it, we're optimistic about this alternative. And we believe that if we conduct a public hearing on July 12th, the local government commission will take the matter up at its regular August meeting. And we feel good about the request that we're making. So I'm okay in allowing you to debate a budget document with a rate of 50 cents as opposed to 52.
Okay.